Stare into a glass of champagne, and the bubbles will carry you away. Myth has it, on the discovery of this 18th century magic, the monk Dom Perignon exclaimed, "Come quickly, I'm drinking stars." This rich blend of history and mystery gives champagne the lure it holds today.
So we're going to have a little tasting of the Tettinger fruit. It's one of the houses that will be featured at Bubbles and Oceans this year.
Araxi wine director and sommelier Samantha Rand uncorks the mystery of this white glove affair. Champagne was poured at Marie Antoinette's court. Napoleon sabered bottles before battle to bring good luck. And here at Araxi in Whistler, these are the drinkable stars of the Bubbles and Oceans after party at the Cornucopia Food and Wine Festival this November.
The very best way to learn about champagne is to taste as much of it as possible. The best place to do something like that is an event like ours, where you get a chance to taste side by side.
Alongside decadent canapés and fruits of the sea at this November 10th event, 10 champagnes and 10 to 15 sparkling wines will be showcased. The name champagne is only given to bottles that have been produced specifically from the chalky-soiled region of Champagne, France. Anything else is sparkling. Look for the label, and then note dates. Vintage champagnes are dated, reserves are not.
Reserve champagnes are made in the traditional house style. So they're taking vintage champagnes from a number of different years and blending it together to make a consistent style. Perhaps the most famous example, maybe for us here in BC, would be Veuve Clicquot. With a vintage, you're getting the fruit from just that year. They only declare vintage in the best vintage years when they feel that the grapes have reach their optimum ripeness for what they were looking for and the characteristics that they're looking for. So in the main part of the dining room for our party, we'll have all of the tables and chairs cleared out.
Here guests will learn about the traditional brut, but it is the Blanc de Blanc I'm keen to learn about.
It's made exclusively with Chardonnay grapes and considered to be not only the most elegant and complex, but also the most powerful of all of the champagnes out there.
A comparison of rosés from Veuve Clicquot and Tintouge will also kick up their effervescent dresses.
They're fun to drink and they're pink, and what girl doesn't like pink bubbles?
Inevitably, we become the bubbly we drink. Charismatic, alive, and moving. Champagne is always a glass of celebration. From Whistler, I'm Nicole Fitzgerald for Shaw TV.